Hello friends, welcome to the second part of trigonometry. In this part we will discuss the problems on the basis of sine theta. Like here I am writing the first question, sine 9a equal plus 12 equal to maximum and minimum value of this equation. So these type of questions you usually see in SSC exams, SSC, banking, any exam you can say. In any exam these type of questions appears, so you have to know the trick how to solve this question, maximum and minimum value. These questions are very important, and last time in the last video or in the introduction video I discussed about the values of sine theta. So sine theta, sine 0 has value 0. If you watched the last video or you have some basics, then sine 90 is 1. But you know, sine 90 is 1, then sine 270 is minus 1. How? This is just based on quadrant. What are quadrant? So there are 4 quadrant. If I write here, this is just for introduction. There are 4 quadrants. There are 4 quadrants. This is known as first quadrant, and angle in first quadrant is less than or equal to 90. Okay, less than or equal to 90, less than 90 basically. So in the second quadrant, this is moving, these quadrants move in anti-clockwise direction, first, second, third, fourth. So in the second, angle is less than 180. In the third, angle is less than 270. And in the fourth quadrant, angle is less than 360. So these are quadrants, and in these quadrant different values are positive and negative, like you after school to college. So in first quadrant all are positive, sine, cos, tan, anything positive. In the second only sine is positive. After school 2 means 10. 10 means in the third quadrant, tan and cot are positive. In the similar way, sine and cosecant are positive in the second quadrant. And in the fourth, after school to college, that are cos is positive. This is the basic thing. Some people know about this, but some don't know. That's why I am discussing here. So if I am writing sine 270, then can I write here sine? You can say sine 180 plus 90. So this is, now I am dealing with what, which quadrant? 180 plus, that means I am dealing with the third quadrant, and in third quadrant only tan is positive. So now I have to sine 90. This is the sine 90. Why it is sine 90? Because I am adding in 180 plus something. If I am 90 plus something, then t ratio changes. But if I am adding in 180 or 360 or 720, then this t ratio will not change. So it will become sine 90. But in the third quadrant, sine is negative. So that's why sine 90 has value minus 1. So basic you have to know in this question. Be frank, just you have to know two things. Major two things. Not wasting time. Major two things, okay. Sine theta, sine A, anything, sine A, okay, sine A, maximum value it can be 1, minimum value it can be minus 1. Just overview, what I want to conclude, this is the conclusion. Sine raised to the power, here 1, so that means any power, sine raised to the power, odd, here I am writing odd. That means sine raised to the power 3, sine raised to the power 5, sine raised to the power 13, any odd power will give me what? Any odd power will give me the value of sine maximum 1 and minimum minus 1. But if there is a power positive, sine power positive, I am just discussing about sine in this video. So in next video I will discuss about cos or any other sine raised to the power even. So sine raised to the power even means that minus 1 raised to the power even. So in the even case, I hope you understand, in the even case, just changing the font size, okay. Now, in the even case, maximum value does not change, maximum value will be 1, but minimum value will be become 0. Like I am writing sine raised to the power 4a. Now this sine is a power of even number. So this will not become minus 1, but this can be 0 because sine 0 is 0. So these are the basic two things you know, sine a, sine a in case of even and odd. Now I am solving some problems that are based on these topics. So let's start the first problem. First problem is sine 9a. So this sine a, its maximum value can be plus 1 plus 12. So its maximum value will be plus 13. I hope you understand this question. Sine raised to the power, sine maximum value, then adding maximum value to 12. Now for obtaining minimum value, minus 1, sine 9a can be minus 1 plus 12. So it's a plus 11. So in this question, this is just simple question. Plus 13 is the maximum value and plus 11 is the minimum value for this problem. I hope this is clear to you. Now moving to next question. In the next question, I am taking sine raised to the power 10a. That means it has two values, maximum and minimum. Its maximum value is 1 plus 15. So maximum value will be 16. And it's for its minimum value, we have to take sine raised to the power 10a equal to 0. So 0 plus 15 is equal to 15. So in this way, like 16 is the maximum value for this equation and 15 is the minimum value. So these types of questions appear in SSC exams. If you like this video and you understand this video, this is a basic concept, basically sine odd and sine even. I will discuss about cos questions also in the next videos. So this, I hope you understand these questions. I will just upload a PDF of this topic. You can go through that PDF and clear your basics. I hope this is the basic thing and the rest is just practice. So I hope these two questions will be clear to you, and in the next video we will discuss other questions on the basis of sine. So thank you so much for watching this video. If you like this video, you can contact me on this number and share your suggestions and your views about this video. Thank you so much for watching this video. Thank you so much. Have a nice day.